Please stand. We're going to do number, whatever it is, Precious Lord, take my hand. Precious Lord, take my hand, lead me on, let me stand. I am tired, I am weak, I am worn. Through the storm, through the night, lead me on to the light. Take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home. When the darkness appears and the light draws near and the day is past and gone, at the river I stand, guide my feet, hold my hand, take my hand, precious Lord, lead me home.
Toward the Lord as we always do, particularly in times of great need. And we begin in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace and peace of God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ be with each of you.
And with your spirit.
Today is a sad day. Today we bid fond farewell to one of the lights in the parish. The day is made sadder because Louis's widow is unable to be with us today. Please keep her in your prayers. In the midst of sadness, we're reminded by the light that burns brightly that the Lord's presence is not gone. It may be hard to see, but it is present. This is our hope. And in this spirit, we welcome everyone, and we begin the largest and the grandest of prayers, the Holy Mass, for Mr. Louis Tan. In the waters of baptism, Louis died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory. Let us pray. Almighty God and Father, it is our certain faith that your Son who died on the cross was raised from the dead, the first fruits of all who have fallen asleep. Grant that through this mystery your servant Louis, who has gone to her rest in Christ, may share in the joy of his resurrection. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. The souls of the just are in the hand of God, and no torment shall touch them. They seemed, in the view of the foolish, to be dead, and their passing away was thought an affliction, and their going forth from us utter destruction. But they are in peace. For if before men indeed they be punished, yet is their hope full of immortality. Chastised a little, they shall be greatly blessed, because God tried them and found them worthy of himself. As gold in the furnace, he proved them, and as sacrificial offerings, he took them to himself. Those who trust in him shall understand truth, and the faithful shall abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are with his holy ones, and his care is with his elect. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. In verdant pastures, he gives me repose. Beside restful waters, he leads me. He refreshes my soul. The Lord is my shepherd. There is nothing I shall want. He guides me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk in the dark valley, I fear no evil. For you are at my side with your rod and your staff that give me courage. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. You spread the table before me in the sight of my foes. You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want. Only goodness and goodness follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord for years to come. The Lord is my shepherd, there is nothing I shall want.
A reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Thessalonians. We do not want you to be unaware, brothers and sisters, about those who have fallen asleep, so that you may not grieve like the rest who have no hope. For if we believe that Jesus died and rose, so too will God, through Jesus, bring with him those who have fallen asleep. Indeed, we tell you this on the word of the Lord, that we who are alive, who are left until the coming of the Lord will surely not precede those who have fallen asleep. For the Lord himself, with a word of command, with the voice of an archangel, and with the trumpet of God, will come down from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. Thus we shall always be with the Lord. Therefore, console one another with these words. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Alleluia, 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 alleluia. I am the resurrection and the life, said the Lord. He who believes in me will not die forever. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. At that time, Jesus answered, I give praise to you, Father, Lord of heaven and earth, for although you have hidden these things from the wise and the learned, ye have revealed them to the childlike. Yes, Father, such has been your gracious will. All things have been handed over to me by my Father. No one knows the Son except the Father, and no one knows the Father except the Son, and anyone to whom the Son wishes to reveal him. Come to me, all you who labor and are burdened, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you and learn from me, for I am meek and humble of heart, and you will find rest for yourselves. For my yoke is easy and my burden light. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's a phrase in the first reading that particularly asks for meditation. Chastised a bit, we hear. Chastised a bit. What is a bit of chastisement? Louis Tan was a boy when war ravaged his homeland. I imagine that there were a few chastisements at that time, and they were larger than being chastised a bit. Deprivations, things of violence, all kinds of worries, all kinds of preoccupations. And one of the ways that we try to deal with such things is we try to reach out. We look around to those who are closest to us, And we ask, sometimes not by words, but by the expressions of our face, the tone of our voice, the way our body is arranged, we ask for something more. We ask for help. And in one way or another, through the grace of God, we're able to receive some sort of assurance, some sort of comfort, usually from those closest to us, those who are around us. And that pattern takes place not only in times of war, but it takes place throughout life. And those little frustrations that gather together and plague us from time to time in life, to those grand and even horrible events in life, particularly the loss of somebody close, particularly the loss of someone who has spent his life trying to bring joy and responsibility and truth to others. Someone who built a life for himself and his spouse and his family. Someone with a heart much larger than he was. But one of the secrets to being able to do such great things is that same sense, of knowing that when things are chastisements, big or small, that when they're present, so too is present a consolation, an assurance. The conviction that this, even though it is a trial, is not going to last. There is more. And when someone has interiorized that sort of thing, it makes life easier. When somebody has interiorized that sort of thing, they can do things that attract attention, admiration from others. And it may not occur to them or to those around them at the time, but part of what those sorts of people are able to do is they're able to prepare for moments like this, for death itself. Death itself is particularly frightened because it's so final, at least as far as our senses go. But if we gather together the sum of all those chastisements, and if we're fortunate enough to have that consolation, we're fortunate enough to have that assurance, then we can arrive at a different interpretation in faith. Then we know that that force, that love, that care that guided us through some of the more difficult chastisements in our life can certainly be with us in a moment of great need. Our prayer is that Louis lived that assurance, that bit of wisdom, that bit of faith, that bit of knowledge, at the very moment he passed away. Our prayer today is also for those gathered next to us and those who are far afield, that they will be able to know some of that same assurance and comfort in the midst of chastisements, large or small. Who knows? Maybe the example that Louis gave in his life would help them immeasurably in his death. We're gathered here today to know that this mourning process, with all of its ups and downs, takes place in the shadow of the resurrection, takes place in the midst of turmoil, in the midst of darkness, with a flickering light. This is our hope. This is our assurance. This is what we cling to in moments like these, when those chastisements seem anything but small. Brothers and sisters, we gather here in sorrow and in faith. We gather here in darkness and in light. We gather our voices together. We present our needs to the one who calls us. In baptism, Lewis received the light of Christ. Scatter the darkness now and lead him over the waters of death. We pray to the Lord. Our brother was nourished at the table of the Savior. Welcome him into the halls of the heavenly banquet. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Many friends and members of our families have gone before us, and they await the kingdom. Grant them an everlasting home with your Son. We pray to the Lord. Many die by violence, war, and famine each day. Show your mercy to those who suffer so unjustly these sins against your love, and gather them to the eternal kingdom of peace. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear us.
Those who trusted in the Lord now sleep in the Lord. Give refreshment, rest, and peace to all whose faith is known to you alone. We pray to the Lord. The family and friends of Louis seek comfort and consolation. Heal their pain and dispel the darkness and doubt that come from grief. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Good and gracious God, send your spirit of consolation to sustain us, to keep us firmly fixed upon the light that does not end. We ask these things through Christ our Lord.
Thank you.
Please join in singing number 457, You Are Mine.
I will come to you in the silence. I will lift you from all your fear. You will hear my voice. I claim you as my choice. Be still and know I am here. I am hope for all who are hopeless. I am eyes for all who long to see. In the shadows of the night, I will be your light. Come and trust in me. Do not be afraid, I am with you. I have called you each by name. Come and follow me. I will bring you home. I love you and you are mine.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Father Almighty. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Louis, we beseech your mercy that he who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty, Eternal God, for it is at your summons that we come to birth, by your will that we are governed, and by your command that we return on account of sin to the earth from which we came. And when you give the sign, we who have been redeemed by the death of your Son shall be raised up to the glory of his resurrection. And so, with the company of angels and saints, we sing to him of your praise, as without end we acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on a night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you."
Thank you.
In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is a chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection, and his ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with St. George and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Oscar, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Louis, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who is united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall be like you for all the ages and praise you without end. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
O, the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give to you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Body of Christ. The body of Christ. body of Christ in you. The body of Christ, Jerry. Body of Christ, Jerry. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ.
Ave Maria. Gratia plena, Maria, gratia plena, Maria, gratia plena, Ave, Ave Dominum. Benedicta tu mulieribus.
God bless you always. Amen.
Et benedictus.
Body of Christ.
Et benedictus fructus.
Body of Christ.
Ventris tui, Jesus. Ave Maria.
The body of Christ. The body of Christ. The body of Christ. Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in a sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Knights of Columbus, Bishop Scanlon Assembly, resolution of condolence in memory of Sir Knight Louis H. Tain. Whereas it has pleased Almighty God in his infinite wisdom to call from our midst our beloved brother who departed from this life, December 21st, 2020, and whereas by his death, our assembly has sustained the loss of an exemplary Catholic and worthy knight. Therefore, be it resolved that while we bow in submission to the will of our Heavenly Father, we mourn the loss of our brother who has been taken from us. And be it further resolved that this testimonial of condolence will be offered to the family of our departed brother knight as an expression of our heartfelt sympathy.
Before we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our brother. May our farewell express our affection for him. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet him again when the love of Christ, which conquers all things, destroys even death itself. Saints of God, come to his aid. Hasten to meet him, angels of the Lord. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. May Christ, who called you, take you to himself. May angels lead you to the bosom of Abraham. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Eternal rest grant unto him, O Lord, and let perpetual light shine upon him. Receive his soul and present him to God the Most High. Into your hands, Father of mercies, we commend our brother Louis in a sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings which you bestowed upon Louis in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to your servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
In peace, let us prepare to take our brother to his place of rest.
stillness we will hear God's voice come home. Come home. May the angels welcome you. May the saints come to your aid. May they lead you into paradise and present your soul to God. Come home, come home, for our love is waiting there. In the stillness we will hear God's voice. Come home, come home. May Christ Jesus take you home. May you have eternal rest. May you dwell forever in God's peace. May you live in eternal life. Come home, come home, for love is waiting there. In the stillness you will hear God's voice. Come home. Come home.
Thank you.